What a lucky person I am. Until yesterday, I was riding around Bulgaria. Now I'm in Bucharest, Romania, and this is the Parliament. This is the second largest building of the world. Man, 83 meters tall. You can't even see it how big it is here. It has 1,100 rooms. Man, huge! And this is the cathedral. Have a look the size.
Good morning. After more than a month spent around Bulgaria, it is time to move to the north. As you already know, maybe you don't, but my plan has changed significantly because many of the countries that I plan to visit are locked down and I cannot visit it. So the original plan was to go from Bulgaria, Romania, Moldova, Ukraine, Belarus, Lithuania, Latvia, Estonia, even for a while in Russia, and then Finland, Norway, and go back to Germany. But in many of those countries, I won't be able to go in. So the plan that I have now is to go to Romania. Today I have to reach Bucharest, it's only around 300 kilometers. And then from Romania, I will try to enter Ukraine, which is still questionable. I don't know, am I able or not, but I will definitely try. From Ukraine, I will go to Belarus. From Belarus, I'll go to Poland, and I will try to take a ferry from Poland to Finland, if it's possible, because Finland also say that foreigners citizens needs to go for 14 days quarantine. I will definitely check this. I will also try to go to Sweden, and if I cannot to go to any of these countries, I'll go straight off from Poland to Germany. I'll try definitely from Germany to go to Norway if it's possible, but let's see. So today's plan is to reach Bucharest. 8 o'clock in the morning, 25 degrees. Because I don't have so many kilometers, as I told you, only 300 kilometers to Bucharest. I'm not on any rush, so it's going to be enjoyable ride. Maybe it will take a little bit longer on Dunau Bridge, but let's see. As you can see, I do not even have a GPS because it's burned out when I arrived in Bulgaria. And I spent the last month without GPS, only map and signs. And now you can tell me, yeah, it's easy in Bulgaria, but now I'm going outside of Bulgaria. So I'm gonna show you that if you have a map, I have a map of Romania. And if you look on the signs, it's fine. In the worst scenario, you can always ask. 80 kilometers of highway, and now I have more 100 kilometers of double lane road till Ruse. And after that I have around 80-90 kilometers to Bucharest. Varna-Ruse road, it's nothing significant. This is not a twisty road or something to enjoy. It is just a straight line, 200 kilometers. I do what I got to do, that's it. After exactly 2 hours and 185 kilometers, I'm in Ruse. As I said before, the road is nothing so special. That's why I did not record so much, because it's nothing to show you. What I'm gonna do now, fuel the tank, probably eat something, and then enter into Romania. This is the border. It is Sunday, so I hope it will be easy to pass, but let's see. Because during the week the traffic is serious, I hope now we'll be fine. Stop here for the bridge
fee for the bridge, but it is free for motorcycles. This is Duna River and this is Duna Bridge. Goodbye Bulgaria, welcome to Romania. I'm gonna spend the next maybe week, maybe more, in Romania. Okay, it took me 15 minutes. No problem whatsoever. No one even asked me about coronavirus or something like that. So, welcome to Romania. Already Bucharest. 11:30, too early. I have a hotel booked, but it's going to be probably after 2 in the afternoon. So I'm gonna stop and eat something and wait. I plan to spend the whole day tomorrow in Bucharest, so I'm gonna show you everything with more details. Today, the point for today is just to get to the hotel before it became too hot, because now it's 30, it's going to be 34 after a few hours. So it's going to be lazy day. I am impressed. At the moment I am in the middle of city center of Bucharest in Radisson Blue Hotel, 5-star hotel. Let me tell you the short story. When I said that I'm going to Romania, a few guys contact me and asked me for meeting or possible riding together, whatever. One of the guys was Nikolai, and he said that if I need accommodation, he can help me. I said, yes, sure, absolutely. And when I arrived here, it turned out he booked a hotel in Radisson Blue, right in the middle of city center, 5-star hotels, and he paid for it. Nikolai, if you watch all of this, thank you very much, but I am just a normal person, like most of you. This is VIP hotel. Let me show you what it is. It's a huge room. Have a look. Of course, I already converted to my creative mess, but it is just outstanding. Let me show the bath. It's a shower. And bath. Oh man. And everything is so nice. I'm just a normal guy. And this is a perfect example how far one normal guy can go with all of you guys, motorcycle community. So I'm gonna spend the night here, and today I'm also in Bucharest. I'm gonna ride around and show you as more as possible before I hit the passes into the north. But so far, absolutely great. Now I'll go down to the Italian restaurant where my host Nicola is chef. So I'm gonna eat. Ooh. It is what I... just about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. This is my host, Nikolai. Nikolai, thank you very much for everything. You're a great man, great hotel, great location. Everything is perfect. And he has this wonderful Ducati Multistrada. So what we're gonna do now, Nikolai?
We're gonna take a small ride here in Bucharest.
Yeah.
A beautiful Paris of the East, they call it.
Yeah.
I show you the nice areas. I'm gonna show you some areas where there's history. Tell you something about the history, and we go with the flow and see what else we can explore.
Sounds great, huh?
Great.
Let's ride. Let's ride. Wonderful. Great man. You surprised me with this wonderful hotel. This is so beautiful area. This is actually a music hall, concert hall. Very, very beautiful. This is a library, and this is a government building. And right in the middle, there is a pylon with heart punched like this, which is mean that Romanian heart was punched by the regime they've got in the past, but now everything is good. It's a beautiful building here where they make all of these crown procedures. Have a look, only so many beautiful buildings here. This is the, like the best spot in Bucharest. All right, my friend, we can go. Let's move further. I will give you space now, if I can. Okay, now we are good to go. Yeah. See this fountains here. National Museum of Romania, and this is beautiful building, CFC Bank. Oh, nice. What a lucky person I am. Until yesterday I was riding around Bulgaria, now I'm in Bucharest, Romania, and this is the parliament. This is the second largest building of the world. Man, 83 meters tall, you can't even see it how big it is here. It has 1,100 rooms. Man, huge! And this is the cathedral. Have a look the size. Oh man, I'm addicted to motorcycle traveling. Military building. The reason I stopped here is because I want to show you this huge building here. This is maybe the biggest unfinished construction work on the world, definitely in Romania. It's supposed to be opened many years ago, but they left it unfinished since Ceaușescu died, how many years, 20 years, 25 years ago. And two companies want to take it to make some hotels, apartments, whatever, but they didn't. So probably they're gonna turn it down. Crazy Romanian stuff. Such a colorful city. There is everything. Business buildings, modern buildings, old buildings, concrete apartments. Definitely deserve more attention. As I told you, I plan to spend tomorrow as well here, so I hope to see even more. This is now Piazza Victoria, and the building over there on the left, it is government building. You can recognize already all of these government buildings with this marble structure, big open space, big boulevards. Everything is big here. This now is Paris Street, and this is actually the most expensive part of the city, with expensive houses. Yeah, very beautiful. It's big villas. Such a pleasure to ride now, Sunday, no traffic, 5:30, wonderful. I really appreciate what Nicolae did for me.
Back opposite there.
Okay. Nice, isn't it? The biggest beer hall in Europe, huh?
The biggest permanent beer hall is huge. They make concerts and I don't know how many thousand people. They have underneath down, then on this side they have some things. And you normally have upstairs the entrance and you have like a balcony up where you also have these big tables.
Already want to take a beer. Let's move. You can see where Hard Rock Cafe is located. Very nice location. Beautiful, huh? Like the arch in Paris.
It's exactly the same,
yeah? Yeah. Oh, nice.
My parking spot. Oh, man. What a pleasure.